Hello everyone, welcome back to AeroHub and welcome to the series of lectures in aerospace structures. And in the last lecture we discussed about the estimation of stress as well as load acting on a complete tension field beam, and also we discussed about what is a tension field beam and what is the application of this tension field beam in aerospace application, especially in the design of a spar. And in this lecture we will see a numerical problem through which you can get a better understanding of how to use the equations to estimate the stress as well as the loads acting on the stiffness as well as the flange of a complete tension field beam, or it is also called a Wagner beam. As you can see in the figure, we have a complete tension field beam and this beam is subjected to a load of 5 kN at the one end, and the total length of the beam is 1200 mm, and the depth of the beam is 400 mm, and the distance between two vertical stiffness is 300 mm. And you can see here the cross sectional area, I have written here the cross sectional area of the stiffener is 300 mm² and for flanges is 350 mm², and the value of D, that is nothing but the width, and B is nothing but the distance between two vertical stiffness, and the thickness of the web is 2 mm, and the Young's modulus is given as 70,000 Nm² and the area moment of inertia, which is nothing but the resistance of a beam against bending, or a resistance of a section against bending, is 2000 mm². We have two moment of inertia. One is area moment of inertia. Next one is mass moment of inertia. Area moment of inertia is nothing but resistance to bending, and mass moment of inertia is nothing but resistance to rotation. Okay, so we have the data and they are asking to find out the maximum stress in the flange, and also they are asking whether the stiffness will buckle. Okay, so we have the formulas to find out the compressive load of a stiffener, and we have to compare the compressive load with respect to the critical load. If the compressive load is more than the critical load, then the stiffness will buckle. Okay, first of all we have to find out the value of alpha, which is nothing but the angle of diagonal tension. Okay, we have to find out the value of alpha first. Then we have to find out the maximum stress acting in the flange. Since I am applying the load in the vertical flange, or not flange, on the top flange, the maximum amount of stress will be acting on the top flange. So I will be estimating the value of force acting on the top flange. Then I will divide the value which I got, that is with respect to the area of the flange. Then you will get the value of stress acting on the flange. So I'll find out the value of alpha, which is nothing but the angle of diagonal tension. Then I will find out the value of force acting on the top flange. From this value I will be getting the value of sigma t, which is nothing but the stress acting on the top flange. Okay, and then I will find out the value of compressive load acting on a stiffener, and then I will find out the value of effective length of this vertical stiffener. Okay, we have certain formulas for effective length, we will see that. And finally I will find out the value of critical compressive stress, and I will compare the value of compressive load acting on the stiffeners with respect to the critical compressive stress, which is found out using the value of effective length or equivalent length. Okay, if the value of critical stress is less than the value of compressive load, the stiffness will buckle. If the value of compressive load we got is less than the value of critical load, the stiffness will not buckle. Okay, so first of all we have to find out the value of alpha. We have the formula for finding out the angle of diagonal tension. Tan power 4 alpha is equal to 1 plus t into d divided by 2 times the area of the flange divided by 1 plus tb divided by the area of stiffness. Okay, So you have the value of thickness of the web, that is 2 millimeter, and the value of D is 400. You can see the figure now. Divided by 2 times the area of the flange. Area of the flange is 350 millimeter square divided by 1 plus TB. Thickness is 2. The value of B is 300 and the area of stiffness is 300. So I'll be getting a value of 0.7143. This is 10 power 4 alpha. And I can reduce this equation. I can find out the value of alpha. Okay, you can try that. Finally, I'll be getting an answer of 42.6 degrees. This is the value of angle of diagonal tension. And in the last lecture, I mentioned that the maximum value of alpha will be 45 degrees. But in the case of aerospace application, the value of alpha will be less than 38 degrees. Okay, you have to keep that in mind. Now, the next question, next part of the solution is to find out the force acting on the top flange. The formula is given by W is a, this is nothing but the moment divided by D plus W by 2 tan alpha. Okay, we have every value. W is nothing but 5 kilonewton. Z is 1200 millimeter. Okay, the value of D is 400 and we have found out the value of alpha. I substitute the value. W is 5 into 1200, that is the total length of the beam. The value of D is 400 millimeter plus 5 divided by 2 times tan. The value of alpha we found out in the last step, that is 42.6 degrees. Okay, now I will be getting the value of force acting on the top flange as 17.7 kilonewton. Okay, I haven't converted the value of into Newton. Here it is 5 kilonewton. Okay. Now we will find out the value of stress acting on the top flange. Sigma T is equal to the force acting on the top flange divided by the area of the flange. This is already given in the question. And the top flange force is 17.7 into 10 power 3 Newton divided by the area of the flange is 350 millimeter square. So I'll be getting an answer of 50.7 Newton per millimeter square. Okay, this is the answer and this is equal to 50.7 megapascal. Okay, so this is the value of maximum stress acting on the top flange. Okay, now we have to find out this is sigma T, that is nothing but 50.7 megapascal, the maximum stress in top flange. Okay, now we have to find out the compressive load acting on the vertical stiffness, and the compressive load is given by capital P is equal to WB by D into tan alpha. Okay, so we have the value of W, that is 5 kilonewton, and the value of B is 300 and the value of D is 400. Tan alpha we've already found out, that is 42.6 degree. So the value I'll be getting is 3.4 kilonewton. This is the value of compressive load acting on the vertical stiffener of the given example. Okay, now we have to find out the value of critical stress, that is pi square EI divided by the equivalent length square. Okay, if you remember the last lecture, I have told that the behavior of a vertical stiffener is similar to the behavior of a column. Okay, and this formula we have used to find out the critical load or crippling load or buckling load of a column. Okay, so E is nothing but the Young's modulus, already given in the question. I is also given. We have to find out the value of LE square, and we have the formula. Equivalent length LE is equal to D divided by root of 4 minus 2B by D. This formula is valid when B is less than 1.5D. Okay, here
the value of B is 300 millimeter and the value of D is 400 millimeter. So 1.5D will be equal to 600 millimeter. So 600 is larger than 300. So this formula is valid. You have to substitute the value of D, B and D, and I will be getting the value of equivalent length of the column. And you can try that and you will be getting an answer of 253 millimeter. This is the value for equivalent length of the vertical stiffness. Okay, now I'll substitute the value of equivalent length in this formula, then I'll find out the value of critical stress. If the critical stress is less than the compressive stress acting on the vertical stiffener, the vertical stiffener will buckle. And if the critical stress is larger than the compressive load acting on the vertical stiffener, there will not be any buckling. Okay, so we'll do that now. We'll find out the value of equivalent length. LE is equal to 400, that is the value of D, divided by root of 4 minus 2B, 2 into 300 divided by D, 400. So I'll be getting the value as 253 millimeter. Okay, now we'll find out the value of P critical. P critical is equal to pi square EI divided by LE square. We are assuming that the vertical stiffness are pinned. Okay, this is free to rotate. Okay, we are not fixing the vertical stiffness, and we are assuming that, or we, the boundary condition is such that the vertical stiffness are pinned. Pin boundary condition. Okay, now I will substitute the value, the pi square, the value of E is 70,000 and the value of I is 2000 divided by 253 square. So I will be getting the value of critical stress as 22 kilonewton. This is the value of critical stress. And I have got the value of compressive load acting on the stiffener as 3.4 kilonewton. Okay, so this value is higher when compared to the compressive load, therefore there is no buckling of the stiffener. Okay, the stiffener will not buckle. Okay, so the result I can write here, the result I got, the value of maximum stress acting on the flange, that is for top flange, is 50.7 megapascal, and the second result is the stiffeners won't buckle, that is P critical is larger than the compressive load, therefore the stiffener will not buckle. Okay, so that's all about this lecture, and we are winding up aerospace structures or aircraft structures too, or airframe structural analysis. Thank you for listening to these lectures, and in the upcoming lectures we will go through the university problems of different universities in India, especially Anna University, VTU, KTU, JNU, as well as most of the deemed universities in India. And we will try to solve some more problem, and we will start a new course, that is Advanced Aerospace Structures, and it is mainly concerned with sizing of airframe components, and stay tuned for that. And the notes which I have used will be sharing in the website, and we will be launching the website as soon as possible. Thank you for your support, and we will be launching a new course as soon as possible. Thank you for your support. Take care.